The 2022 UCE exam results indicate that 349,459 candidates registered for UCE. Among these, 175,768, that is 50.3%, were male, while 173,691, that is 49.7%, were females. This indicates a fall in the number of girls sitting for this exam, despite higher numbers of girls registering for primary leaving exams. The Education Minister and First Lady Janet Kataha-Museveni is concerned that about 30,000 of the girls who finish primary leaving exams do not make it to Senior 4.
We noted that not only had the number of girls completing PLE caught up with the number of boys, but also the number of girls was significantly higher than that of the boys. Unfortunately, however, in 2022, this positive trend appears to have reversed in favor of the boys once again. Consequently, we at the Ministry of Education and Sports consider this a matter of great concern, and we find it necessary to provide an explanation to the nation regarding this challenge that affects the education and development of the girl child.
To solve this problem, the minister has instructed the permanent secretary to investigate the matter and come up with a detailed report that will help the ministry come up with solutions. The minister further expressed concern that student absenteeism has increased, with at least 0.3% of candidates who registered for UCE but did not sit for the final exams.
Therefore, instructed the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Education and Sports to conduct a study in this area that we may understand the issues at hand and authoritatively inform the nation. Now, once more, I regrettably note that the cases of absenteeism that have been decreasing, meaning some 560 candidates over that of 2020, as I noted during the release of PLE 2022 results. This is of great concern to the ministry and therefore must be of concern to all the stakeholders.
In 2022, for the first time, the Uganda National Examinations Board examined Chinese language with a total of 134 candidates sitting for the exams, and 124, that is 92.5% of them, passed. The minister notes that this is a good move towards global integration.
The knowledge of Chinese is vital for us, given the ever-increasing levels of engagements between Uganda and China in the various fields, educational, cultural, technological, and commerce. This is also why, as a country, we must ensure that our people can communicate in these major languages such as French, German, Arabic, and even Swahili at the East African level.
Meanwhile, the State Minister for Higher Education, Jean Chrysostom Muyingo, notes that whereas the new academic year began on the 6th of February, hundreds of school-going children are still at home. He wants a policy designed to compel all parents to take their children to school.
The number of Ugandans who are of the school-going age have not yet reported to back to school for this academic term. This is equally dangerous, and I want to appeal to the parents, to the leadership, local LOC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, councillors, members of parliament, to join our efforts to mobilize all our children of school-going age to go back to school as soon as yesterday.
Professor Mary Okwakol, the board chairperson for UNEB, notes that whereas the UCE exams were conducted successfully, the board faced a lot of difficulty in conducting the exams in the Ebola-affected districts of Mubende and Kassanda that were under lockdown at the time of the exams.
At the examination centers, the restrictions placed on movements of persons initially impacted the movement of examination officials. The board then worked with the police, the offices of the resident district commissioners, and the area supervisors to deal with these challenges adequately. We thank God that no fatalities were reported among the candidates or the field personnel.
In the year 2022, UCE candidature increased by 16,063, that is 4.8%, from 333,396 in 2020 to 349,459 in 2022. A total of 349,459 candidates registered from 3,703 centers across the country. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.